I'm Mike Dardis. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you here tomorrow on WLWT News 5. And now we have company for some reason.
I know, it's your turn.
Mike, we're going to ask you 55 random questions in a short amount of time. Are you ready?
Ready.
Can I do the first one so I can get out of here?
Of course. If I don't let you do the first one, you're going to hit me.
If we were doing a duet, what would it be?
I don't know if it's a duet, but that Taylor Swift song, Trading Spaces, Blank Spaces, whatever. It's either going to last forever or go down in flames. I say it's going to last forever as an anchor team, you and me.
Okay, yeah. Right answer.
Thank you very much. All right, go ahead.
Mike, what's the coolest thing about being on TV?
Helping people. You can do great stories and make a big difference.
What's one pre-show ritual?
Getting out to the studio 5 minutes before Cherie so I can get her iPad on and everything set for her because she gets out here at the last minute.
What was the first thing you thought of this morning?
Why did I stay up till 3 in the morning watching on DVR The Voice again?
What's a Mike Dardis breakfast look like?
2 spoonfuls of peanut butter or 4 strips of microwave bacon.
Mike, what was your most embarrassing TV moment?
Wearing purple shorts on the air in a small market. Sometimes we used to wear shorts under the desk. We don't do that anymore. And at the end of the show, I actually stood up like this and I thought the show was over and there was a camera still rolling on the end of the newscast and everybody saw I was wearing purple shorts.
Do you have any quirky food habits?
When I go into a restaurant and I eat grated cheese, instead of sprinkling it on, I take the top completely off and I literally pour it on my pizza or my pasta.
I do that too.
Yeah.
What's your favorite home-cooked meal?
Pizza or pasta? Spaghetti and meatballs, I love it.
What's one thing people would be surprised to know about you?
I'm a numbers nerd, and once something's in my mind, I don't forget it, as my co-anchor Cherie knows. I can tell you every score of every Super Bowl going all the way back to the late 60s.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever eaten?
I went into the freezer late at night and I thought I was eating a treat that had chocolate and ice cream, but it was actually a dog treat instead, and I ate a frozen dog treat.
If you could switch lives with anyone for a day, who would it be?
Either one of my kids, no responsibility, the life of Riley, get to have fun all the time and they get to do it over again the next day.
Mike, what would you bring on a one-way trip to Mars?
My DirecTV Sunday NFL ticket package so I can watch every football game.
What is the best advice your parents ever gave you?
Best advice my parents ever gave me, don't take the path of least resistance. Tackle your problems head on.
What is an age you'd like to revisit?
22. I loved college, but I hated studying and schoolwork and tests, so I'll go right after college to the age of 22.
What is a cause that you're passionate about?
I love charitable work when it involves children because they can't help themselves, so I love trying to help them.
What was your first car?
A Hyundai when I was, I think, 18 years old.
If you weren't a journalist, what would you be doing?
I wish I had a great answer for this, but probably because I talk so much, either an attorney or a salesman.
Do you have any guilty pleasures?
It's not really a guilty pleasure, but I really love on a nice day, preferably after a round of golf, a nice chilled glass of beer and a cigar out on the patio.
What's something that you own that you truly cherish?
I have a box in my closet of all of my mementos of my father. He was an investigator for years, involved in Watergate, worked at Sports Illustrated, and I saved a lot of those things, and I really looked up to him in many ways.
What's one thing you have left on your bucket list?
Huh. I think you stumped me on that one. You'll have to get me on the 2018 version of 55 Questions. I don't know if there's really anything that I still want to do that I haven't done. I haven't been to Hawaii. How's that? That sounds simple, but I've never been to Hawaii. I'd love to go.
What advice would you give to an aspiring journalist?
Just always be yourself. Don't be afraid to ask tough questions. And if you're on TV, just be yourself. Don't try to pretend like you're somebody else.
What's one skill that you wish you had?
Juggling chainsaws. No. Actually, singing. There's nothing better than watching a rock concert, and sometimes you dream that you could be that person that could get up in front of 50,000 people and sing, but I can't sing a lick.
Out of all the hobbies in the world, Mike, what's one you'll never give up?
I don't know if it's a hobby, but eating junk food. I love nachos and I love all that late night stuff like wings, unfortunately too much. As an anchor, sometimes you can't do that.
What was your first job?
Working at a golf driving range, driving around that little tractor that people try to hit off the range.
Well, since you're in the industry, do you care to give it a go?
Yeah, I'm not in the industry anymore. I'm no Sergio Garcia, that's for sure, but I can at least pretend and miss. See, that's why I'm not in golf anymore.
Mike, if you wrote an autobiography, what would the title be?
Going back to the previous answer, just be yourself. Just be authentic and don't be phony. That's a long title, but that's basically what I'm thinking.
What's a cause that you're passionate about?
I you know, anything that involves children. I love a lot of the charities that I get involved in that help kids, sick kids, or kids that don't have advantages that others do. There's a group here in Cincinnati called A Kid Again, and they get to go out to Kings Island and the zoo and things. You know, these are families where their kids are really, really ill, and I really love being involved in that.
Can you take a look at that TV and answer the question?
Sure.
Hey, Dad, I know you love rock music, but what's your favorite band?
Well, my first concert and my favorite band of all time, U2. And fortunately, Haley, thanks for the question. I got a chance to go with my daughter to the U2 concert in Chicago last year on my birthday, and I'll never forget it.
What's the best thing about being a dad?
It's the whole thing. It's remembering that they were babies and you take them all the way up through the maturation process and now they're teenagers and the ups and the downs, and you played a role in all of that.
What's the hardest thing about being a dad?
I'm an impatient man, and as a parent, that's not a good thing because your patience is always tested as a parent.
Do your kids think it's cool that you're on TV?
This is going to be a cliche answer, but yeah, when it benefits them. And the funny thing is, even after it benefits them, they say, Dad, it's not all about you, you know. I'm like, yeah, I know, I just did this for you. But anyway, yeah, usually if they could do something fun that involves my job, they like it.
What's a typical weekend like at your house?
Well, just like this past weekend, my son is in AAU sports and football, and my daughter's a singer, and she's a water polo player. It's just running around all the time, running them to different venues.
Out of the three people that are on those pictures right there, who is your favorite?
Well, I'm not going to be wishy-washy about this one here. I love these two guys, but as guys, they don't really care. Women, on the other hand, they can be a little more sensitive. So knowing that and knowing how to handle this, I'm going to say Cherie Pilello is my favorite of the three. And plus, I sit a foot from her every day, and she would probably punch me if I didn't say her.
What's the biggest interview you've ever done?
Two, Michael Jordan and former President Bill Clinton. And neither one of them was a one-on-one interview, but walk and talk kind of interviews, but they were both fascinating to chat with.
Best athlete of all time?
Michael Jordan, best basketball player to ever play. And then just for fun for a couple years, he decided to play baseball, and he played double-A baseball at a high level. Hadn't picked up the game in years and years and years, and he did fine with it, so he's amazing, yeah.
Greatest gift you've ever received?
My dog, Sammy, of course. He's now 10 years old, and I hadn't had animals for years and years, and it's been a great pet.
How about the greatest gift you've ever given?
Well, I'm about to give it again, but my daughter turned 16 a year ago, and she's a great kid, so I actually got her a car, and my son's begging me for the same, so probably a car.
Mike, what's the bravest thing you've ever done?
I would say I hate heights. And one time at Knott's Berry Farm in California, I went on something called the parachute drop, where they bring you up about 70, 80 feet in the, like 7, 8, or 10 stories up in the air, and then they dangle you there for like seemingly forever and bring you back down. I hate heights, and I did that for my kids, and I'll never do it again.
What's one story that you've covered that you'll never forget?
9/11. I worked in Philadelphia at the time. We were an hour and a half away, and it was something, a lot of our local families were affected, so definitely 9/11.
What is the best part about your job?
Just all the great people we get to meet, we're the liaison between the viewer and some of the folks that we do stories on, and you know, we get to tell some great stories and we get to hear them from some great people.
What about the hardest part?
It can wear on you because unfortunately a lot of the stories that we do are about crime and tragedy and heartbreak, and sometimes you go home at night and it's difficult to deal with all the things you've been talking about all week.
What do you do to decompress?
When I get home after a show, I'll go home and I'll get down in the basement and just flip the television on for a couple of hours and watch what I always describe around here as just mindless television, where you just don't have to think, just to kind of decompress.
What's something you'd like to say to the Channel 5 viewers?
That I've been doing this for a long time, and honestly, you have a really special news team here in Cincinnati that you're watching, with Cherie and me and George and Kevin. It doesn't come along often where you get a group together like this, so just relaying that message just from the inside out, you really have something special that you get to be a part of.
What's the most nervous you've ever been?
One time, my high school sister was getting bullied by 4 or 5 guys, and I was off at college, and she was telling me about this. So I came back from college and waited for the five guys after school and took all five of them on, basically, wondering what was going to happen. And it all worked out, and they all backed down, and they left my sister alone.
What's the movie that made you cry?
Saving Private Ryan. My dad was a World War II vet, and he told me that first scene was as authentic as it ever gets. And at the end, when the man is in the cemetery and all of his friends died in the war, and he turns to his wife and he says, "Was I a good man?" That really hit me, and really sad.
What is the biggest learning experience of your life?
We all say it when we're parents, but it's true. You're humbled as a parent. You know, you get respect from people at work, you get respect from everybody you meet, and then at home you have to earn respect from the people that you've raised. So I would say that's the most humbling experience and the most challenging.
Are you done talking about yourself?
I've tried. I wouldn't have talked about myself if they didn't put this camera in my face. All right.
No. Okay, Mike, I have one last question.
Yes.
Is this the strangest interview you've ever done?
No. But I can't tell you what it was.
We all have
one.
Bye.
See ya. Thanks.